They did it! They finished Star Wars! They made all of them! Now, it's up to you. You're making a Star Wars fan film, that's great. You need lightsabers. With free open source software, Blender, let's do it. First, you must construct a lightsaber. You can use cardboard tube, or PVC, or bamboo, or a sawed-off broom handle, don't tell mom, or angle iron. You can use an old flashlight. Take the guts out and attach the blade in there with a screw. Then I'm decorating it with chrome tape, because if I'm not using the chrome tape on this, then what? Marking your blade at intervals will make it way easier to trace when there's a lot of motion blur. Add kyber crystals to taste, and you're done. Swing that thing around! We're gonna add the effects two ways. The hard way, then the easy way. Hop on into Blender. So it's easy enough to get a nice lightsaber glow in Blender. Create a new emission material, and crank it on up. To see the glow, make sure you're rendering an Eevee with bloom enabled. Look at that! However, when we load in our background video, that nice glow disappears because Blender's trying to preserve the alpha or something. So, we're gonna do something kinda cool. Create a plane and slide it on into the background. Give it a new material. Make it an emission material. And for the color, make it an image. But we're not gonna use an image, we're using our video. Scale the plane up to fill the whole background. Check auto refresh, give it a zillion frames, and set vector to window. Now the video will fill the camera view. Change it from repeat to clip to make it a little nicer. So you can just animate a glowing cylinder on the end of the lightsaber, but that's not going to deform well when we get a lot of motion blur. So instead, create a new plane. Tab into edit mode and select a vertex. Hit F3 and search for hook to new object. Do the same for the other four vertices. Now in object mode, you can control each point individually. Give it that glow material and it's looking good. Turn on auto keyframing and just start going through, lining it all up. A few things to speed up your process. Number one, shrink those empties. Number two, select the lightsaber object, and in the outliner, create a new restriction, selectability. Turn it off so you can't accidentally select the lightsaber when you're trying to select the hooks. In fact, if you turn off selectability for everything except the hooks, you can just hit A and grab rotate them all at once. That's really convenient. Number three, so you can see what you're doing, go into the object properties for the saber blade and turn the display to wire. You can turn it back on later. Now it's a lot easier. Go through frame by frame, lining up the empties with the edges of the lightsaber. This is where those marker lines on the blade come in handy. A lot of times it's best to line up every third or fifth frame, then go through and refine if you need to. Hey, I dig it, but what about when it goes behind that space ladder? We need to put that space ladder back in front. Piece of cake! Duplicate the back layer, bring it to the front, and in edit mode, hit K to use the knife tool and trace out that ladder, hitting enter when you're done. Delete all the non-ladder faces, and look at that! Works with the glow and everything. As a final touch, I'm going to open up the video in a video player and save a screen grab of a frame where the lightsaber's out of the way. In Blender, I'm going to do what we did for the background, but using that new image as the texture. Don't forget to set vector to window. Now, wherever the plane is, you see the new image. I'm going to cover just the lightsaber and animate it sliding out of the way. Super easy! Okay, so, that's the hard way. And it'll basically always work, the brute forcing it. But let's say the lightsaber isn't moving much, though. Notice I've added some little tracking dots. Wouldn't it be cool if the computer could just connect those? Yes! Alright, so we're going to open up a new motion tracking workspace and load in our video. Control click on one of the dots, maybe scale it up a little bit, do the other one, and hit track forward. If one of the trackers loses the dot, just go to the bad frame, put the tracker back on the dot, and keep tracking. Alright, go to solve, geometry, and link empty to track. And then we've got our empties right there on the dots. Alright, in the top view, let's make a cube. In edit mode, scale it so it points upwards with the origin at the base. Make it glow. Now in the constraint tab, use a copy location constraint. Select that base empty with the eyedropper. Then use a stretch 2 constraint and select the other empty. Hey! Turn volume variation to 0 and set the rest length to line up with the other empty. Scale the blade to change the thickness. Yeah! Make your blade as big as you want. I won't judge. But Ian, you say. Yes? I would say back. You said you'd teach us how to make lightsaber in Blender. You only showed a lightsaber blade. That seems unfairly semantic at this point, but let's do it! Create a cylinder. Right-click to shade smooth, and in the Object Data tab, select Auto Smooth to keep stuff crisp. There are a few techniques that can be handy for something like this. Control-R adds edge loops. You can scroll up to add multiple loops. Selecting faces can be a pain, but if you hold down the Alt key, it'll select a whole loop. Add the Shift key to select multiple loops at once. Extruding pushes stuff in or out. To keep stuff from getting weird, hit Alt-E to bring up the extrusion menu and specify along normals to have them go straight. Add loops, extrude, extrude. Extrude, add loops, extrude. I for inset, E for extrude, inset, extrude. Control B can give you a nice bevel for rounded edges. Make a new material, metal. Slide it with the metallic slider and turn down the roughness. Add a new material slot with a new material, black. Change the base color and click assign. Done! Make another material, but make it kind of an orange copper. It's copper! I'm going to slide open a new panel and open up the shader editor. Create a new image texture node and plug it into the roughness slot. Load up an image with some good texture. It's a quick way to get some nice realism. And I'm not going to give it a button, because any half-brained enemy could obviously use the force to just turn it off. Instead, I'm going to install a combination lock inside the hilt that has to be force unlocked. Your opponent could probably infer the combo via force meditation, but that's when you get him! But Ian, you say, I want to make a movie where I get to hold the CG lightsaber. What? You ludicrous straw man. No, that's why I made you make one out of garbage. Unless you want to use a 3D tracking setup, which... You probably don't. Just use the force! Obi-Wan, I hate you. Brother Anakin, do not attempt this, for you see, I have the ground of highness. Obi-Wan, you do not fully respect my abilities. Behold! Where'd you get all those cute little lightsabers?
Why don't you ever call Tim with this stuff? Alright, yeah, cause of, yeah, the accident. Yeah, with the angle iron.